Hello friends, let us start with our new topic, stress and strain curve. Before going to start stress and strain curve, we should know the basic meaning of the stress and strain. Okay, and Hooke's law is also necessary. So let us know what is stress. Stress is the restoring force per unit area. Okay, let us understand with this an example. When you are sitting on a couch, it gets deformed, and after some time it regains its original shape and size. Have you wondered why this occurs? Yes, the main reason behind this is the stress. When you sit on the couch, your body weight acts as a force, and due to this force, your body weight, a stress is developed inside the couch which opposes your body weight, and this leads to the formation again, regain of the body original shape. Now what is strain? Strain can be simply defined as the change in dimension by its original dimension. In the above example, you have seen that the couch has deformed. This deform of the couch is the strain only. Okay, now what is Hooke's law? Hooke's law states that whenever stress increases, the strain also increases, but it is applicable up to certain limit. Okay, let's start stress and strain curve. This is strain versus stress curve for a metal such as a copper. Okay, the point from O to A represent a straight line. This straight line is known as elastic region, and Hooke's law is valid up to this only. So what do you mean by elastic region? Suppose we stretch a copper wire which is of 20 cm, and we stretch it up to 25 cm. After some time, the copper wire regains its original length, that is from 25 cm to 20 cm, and this behavior of the wire is known as elastic behavior, and the region which is showing that elastic behavior is known as elastic region. Okay, now consider the point A to B. Okay, the point from A to B is known as partial elastic region or point. What is partial elastic region? Partial elastic region means, suppose we stretch a wire of 25 cm to 30 cm. Okay, now the wire tries to regain its original length, but it doesn't completely regain its original length, that is from 30 cm to 28 cm. Here it doesn't regain its original length, that is 25 cm. So it is showing a nature of partial elastic region. Okay, the region from A to B is partial elastic region. Understand? Now consider the point B to C. Okay, the region from B to C is known as plastic region. What? Plastic region. What do you understand by plastic region? Suppose you stretch a wire of 28 cm to 32 cm. Okay, now the wire does not regain its original length. It stays up to 32 cm. The elongation will continue. If we apply a little force after the point C, that is the stress, if we apply a little stress, the wire breaks, and this point is known as fracture point. Okay, I hope that you understand the concept. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. If you like the video, then please share it and subscribe.